from the corners of the country, from the cities and the farms, with years and years of living tucked up underneath their arms. They walk away from everything just to see a dream come true. So God bless the boys who make the noise on 16th Avenue. With a million-dollar spirit and an old flat-top guitar, they drive to town with all they own in a $100 car. 'Cause one time someone told them about a friend of a friend they knew, who owns, you know, a studio on 16th Avenue.
The year was 1982, and Tom Schuyler and his new wife had purchased a small bungalow near the area of Nashville's Hundred Oaks Mall and began settling into their married life together. It was late one Friday night, and Tom was just picking around on the guitar at home. He didn't have any song ideas on his mind. This was not an instance where he thought, "Hey, I've just come up with a great idea. I can't wait to start writing." Nonetheless, some lyrics came to him, and he jotted them down. In short order, Schuyler had worked up three verses. Then he decided to stand back and take a look at what he had so far. His assessment was that this new piece was too much of an industry song, which would mean very little to the general public as a whole. Not containing a chorus, the tune didn't even have the structure of a commercial song, so Tom just threw it in a desk drawer. He did give it a title, 16th Avenue. About 3 months later, he played it for his publisher, Even Stevens, who was working a lot with Eddie Rabbit then and had a publishing company on Music Row. Stevens asked Tom if he was working on anything. Schuyler told him, "Yes, but I don't think it's very commercial." Tom played the song for him, and Stevens' eyes got big as saucers. He said, "Where did that come from?" Tom said he didn't know, that it just popped into his head one night. Even said, "Well, work on it some more." Schuyler admits to being an absurdly practical guy, and as he was preparing to come to Nashville to pursue a career as a songwriter, he had saved up enough money so he wouldn't have to stay in the boarding houses along Music Row, or live in his car, or do any of the other desperate things mentioned in the song. But Tom observed other people who did, and he listened to their stories. Once Schuyler had finished 16th Avenue, still without a chorus, he did a little demo of the tune, and it got into the hands of Jerry Smith, who had worked with a lot of new artists over the years to help them get their start. Smith was plugging some songs for Even Stevens and Eddie Rabbit, and he took 16th Avenue and another song Tom had written, My Old Yellow Car, over to Billy Sherrill's office at Columbia. Jerry came back to report that Billy liked both tunes, but My Old Yellow Car was his favorite. A couple of days later, Cheryl called Tom at the publishing house to set up a meeting. A chat with the legendary producer was quite a thrill for the young songwriter. Billy was very generous with his time, and he ended up recording both 16th Avenue and My Old Yellow Car with Lacy J. Dalton, a singer Cheryl was producing at the time. My Old Yellow Car was used only as an album filler for Dalton, but the song did become a top 10 hit for Dan Seals 3 years later, in 1985. Columbia issued Lacy's cut of 16th Avenue as a single. It debuted on Billboard magazine's country playlist on September 11, 1982, and was progressing up the chart at a steady pace when the song was picked to open the 1982 Country Music Association Awards telecast. As Dalton performed it live on the main stage, a montage of old and new clips of downtown Nashville and photos of would-be stars walking the streets carrying their guitar cases were shown on the big screen behind her. Schuyler thought it was a great presentation. As a songwriter, Tom Schuyler composed tunes recorded by over 200 different artists. He himself appeared on the charts, first as a solo performer for Capitol Records, then as a member of the trio SKO, with fellow tunesmiths Fred Knobloch and Paul Overstreet, which charted 7 singles in the mid-1980s, including the number one hit, Baby's Got a New Baby. Schuyler was eventually made chairman of the Country Music Association and headed RCA Records' Nashville division from 1992 to 1995. Under his watch at RCA, he signed singer Kenny Chesney and the band Lone Star to the label and played a significant role in launching the careers of Martina McBride and Sarah Evans. From time to time, when Tom hears Lacy J. Dalton's recording of 16th Avenue from more than 30 years ago, he's reminded what a fine record it was, how well Billy Sherrill produced it, and how great Lacy's vocal was. Of all of Schuyler's compositions, 16th Avenue is the song most identified with him, although to this day he still believes it to be an insider song and was surprised when Dalton's record, as great as it was, managed to climb to number 7 in Billboard, no doubt helped by its showcase on the CMA telecast. Tom wrote songs that fared much better on the charts, some even reaching number 1, such as Kenny Rogers' Love Will Turn You Around, Michael Martin Murphy's A Long Line of Love, and Earl Thomas Conley's Love Out Loud. Many times the bigger hits aren't always the ones remembered, but people remember 16th Avenue. Some call it the songwriter's anthem, and to Tom, that's quite an honor.
It looks so uneventful, so quiet and discreet. But a lot of lives were changed down on that little one-way street. 'Cause they walked away from everything just to see a dream come true. So God bless the boys who make the noise on 16th Avenue.